Precision of doing an old school trade and just kind of working constantly to get better and faster and smoother at it. Everything that's done here, when we take apart ribs and sides of beef, we just do it using a hacksaw, like they would have done a century ago. Mostly one or two knives throughout the day. Most of my work is done using a bony knife, and then I also use a scimitar to cut steaks and to break down larger cuts of beef. Most of our beef is sourced from Frank at Scotch Mountain Farms in Meaford, Ontario. He raises Black Angus cattle. He's been doing it the same way on his family farm for five generations. They feed on grass and then they're finished with a mixture of different grains. Meat is dry aged, which gives it a very unique flavor. The longer it hangs, the more it dries out, which concentrates the flavors and lowers the moisture content in the meat. When you're cooking a piece of meat with less moisture, you're better able to achieve a nice crust on a steak that you're going to sear. You create a chemical reaction called the Maillard reaction, which builds a lot of flavor in the meat. Here at Côte de Bœuf, our specialty is a bone-in prime rib steak. In a French restaurant, a Côte de Bœuf would be a large steak to be served between three or four people at your table. It'll go on our flat top instead of an open grill. We season it nicely with salt and pepper. We cook it in duck fat until it's medium rare. The reason I got into being a butcher was because it spoke to my family heritage. My great-grandfather ran a butcher shop here in Toronto in the early 1900s. It was kind of dear to me, so when given the opportunity to work for Teo as a chef and a butcher, it immediately called to me. And I said, you know what, this is something I want to get into. And here we are, 10 years later, still doing it, servicing the needs of our clients here in Toronto.